In Luke chapter 5, Jesus does some incredible things. He heals this paralyzed guy, and then he calls a tax collector to come follow him, and this tax collector throws a party, and he wants to bring all his tax collector friends to see Jesus. And Jesus says this, "I'm living for God's glory." He is God, and he's living for God's glory. So you're not God, but you can live for God's glory. And he said this, in this party he threw, Matthew threw, this tax collector Matthew or Levi, he throws this party. He invites all his unbelieving friends, and the Pharisees and the Sadducees, the religious people show up, and then Jesus said, they start complaining about Jesus, and Jesus says, look, the well don't need a physician, but the sick do, and I've come to seek and to save that which was lost. Living for God's glory really means to set aside what I think and live for what God thinks. And God thinks that we should be about helping people find him. So whether I'm a preacher or whether I'm a teacher or whether I'm a baker, candlestick maker, whatever you are, your life is to be lived for God's glory, not for your own. So when we adjust our lives to Jesus, we find life in him, and our vocation then, wherever he places us, we become ministers in disguise that we might live in such a way for his glory. That's exactly what Jesus did and what Jesus wants us to do. So find your purpose in living all for the glory of God, no matter your vocation, no matter your location, because you surrender those things when you come to Christ. Live differently.